إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وأحسن الهدى هدى محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. Indeed, all praise and thanks belong to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As such, we praise Him, we thank Him, we seek His help, and we ask for His forgiveness. Whomsoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guides to a straight path, there's none that can misguide them. Whomsoever He allows to go astray, there's none that can mislead them. And I bear witness that there's nothing that deserves to be worshipped other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, alone without any partner. And I bear witness that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam is a slave and the messenger of Allah. To proceed, indeed, the best of speech is the speech of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the best of guidance is the guidance of His messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And the worst of things, the worst of affairs, are those which are newly introduced matters into the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For every newly introduced matter is a bid'ah, it is a cursed religious innovation. And every religious innovation is misguidance, and every misguidance leads to the hellfire. We ask Allah to protect us all from it. Anas ibn Malik radiyallahu anhu قال جاء رجل إلى رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم فقال يا رسول الله متى الساعة؟ قال وما عددت لساعة؟ قال حب الله ورسوله. قال فإنك مع من أحببت. قال أنس رضي الله عنه فما فرحنا بعد الإسلام فرحا أشد من قول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم فإنك مع من أحببت. قال أنس فأرجو أن أكون معهم، يعني فأنا أحب الله سبحانه وتعالى ورسوله وأبا بكر وعمر رضي الله عنهما، وأرجو أن أكون معهم وإن لم أعمل بأعمالهم. Anas ibn Malik, this great companion of the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام, he narrates that a person came to the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام and he said, يا رسول الله, when is the last hour? When is the hour? Basically the Qiyamah. The Prophet said to him, what have you prepared for the hour? Without giving him that answer, of course, because neither the Prophet knows that, only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Said, what have you prepared for it? And he said, the love of Allah and His Messenger. I prepared the love of Allah and His Messenger. And the Prophet said to him, فَإِنَّكَ مَعَ مَنْ أَحْبَبْتَ. You will be with those whom you love. You will be with those whom you love. And Anas, after this, he made a comment. He said, nothing made us happier. Nothing pleased us more after accepting Islam than the words of Rasulullah, you are with the one, or you will be with the one whom you love. And Anas said, I love Allah and His Messenger, and I love Abu Bakr, and I love Umar, and I hope that I would be along with them, even though I have not done the deeds that they did. So the Sahaba became very happy because of the love of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam they had for Allah and His Prophet. So, my dear brothers and sisters, this is the principle and the rule. إِنَّكَ مَعَ مَنْ أَحْبَبْتَ. You are with the ones whom you love. So we need to look into our hearts. We need to check our hearts. What types of feelings do we have regarding Abu Bakr, regarding Umar رضي الله عنه, and not just them, but all of the Sahaba. All of the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam? Do we love them? What is our regard about them? Do we respect them? So not just Abu Bakr and Umar, but all of them. Whether they were from al-Ashara al-Mubashara, those 10 whom the Prophet gave the glad news, the good news of Jannah, that there will be guaranteed Jannah. Whether they were from the Muhajireen or the Ansar, whether they were from the Prophet's family, from Ahlul Bayt, whether they were from those who attended the Battle of Uhud and Badr, and so on and so forth. So all of these Sahaba, without any exception, any person who was blessed to see the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in his life and he died as a Muslim, and he is from the best of the people. He is the best of mankind. And this is what the Prophet told us. Whether he was with the Prophet his whole life, whether he was with the Prophet for a moment, or even if he just saw him, he is from the Sahaba radiallahu anhum ajma'in. And the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, he said, لا تسبوا أصحابي فوالذي نفسي بيده لو أنفق أحدكم مثل أهد ذهب ما بلغ مد أحدهم ولا نصيفه. He said alayhi salatu wasalam, and pay attention to his words. He said, Do not curse my companions by him in whose hand my soul is, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If one of you were to contribute the amount of gold equal to Uhud, the mountain of Uhud, it would not amount to as much as the handful of one of them, or even half. No one amongst us, a non-Sahabi, no one after the Sahaba, if anyone were to give an amount of gold which is equivalent to the size of the mountain of Uhud, if you've been to Medina, if you've seen the mountain of Uhud, it wouldn't be equal to half a handful of what one companion gave. Fi sabilillah, subhanallah. This is a comparison between us or people after the Sahaba to the Sahaba radiallahu anhum. So this clearly shows the status of the companions of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. So we're here today to check our hearts, inshallah ta'ala. Do we love the Sahaba? Do we love the companions of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam? Do we have any animosity or grudge against them, as some people express? So the love of the Sahaba, my dear brothers and sisters, could be a way for you to Jannah. And hatred for them is a way for people to go to the hellfire. May Allah protect us. In all of this, we have the source for it. We have the Quran, and we have the Sunnah of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. Allah Azza wa Jal says, وَإِذَا قِيلَ لَهُمْ آمِنُوا كَمَا آمَنَ النَّاسِ قَالُوا أَنُؤْمِنُوا كَمَا آمَنَ السُّفَهَاءِ. When the people are asked, meaning at the time of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, from the munafiqeen, when they are asked to believe like the people believe, meaning the Sahaba, they said, should we believe like these foolish ones? But indeed, they are the foolish ones. They are from the kuffar and munafiqeen. So, in our deen, my dear brothers and sisters, loving the Prophet's companions, it is from our iman. It is from our belief. So, if we know the status of the Prophet's companions, alayhi salatu wasalam, we will never dare to say anything which might hurt them or hurt the Prophet in turn. The Prophet, alayhi salatu wasalam, in a hadith which we have repeated many times in this minbar, that he said, my ummah will split into different sects. In fact, he mentioned 73. And he said, only one of them will be saved. And then the companions asked him, who are those saved people? Who are the saved people, the saved sect, the saved group? He said, مَا أَنَا عَلَيْهِ وَأَصْحَابِي. What I am upon today and my companions, who follows me and my companions. My companions, he mentioned his companions, sallallahu alayhi wasallam. So you can see clearly from this that the Sahaba are part of our deen. They are part of our deen. And criticizing the Sahaba is similar to criticizing the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam is reported to have said, فَمَنْ أَحَبَّهُمْ فَبِهُبِّي أَحَبَّهُمْ وَمَنْ أَبْغَضَهُمْ فَبِبُغْضِي أَبْغَضَهُمْ وَمَنْ آذَاهُمْ فَقَدْ آذَانِي وَمَنْ آذَانِي فَقَدْ آذَى اللَّهُ وَمَنْ آذَى اللَّهُ فَيُوشِكُ أَنْ يَأْخُذَهُ. The Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, he says, whoever loves them, the companions, whoever loves them, it is out of love of me that he loves them. And whosoever hates them, it is out of hatred for me that he hates them. And whoever harms them, harms the Sahaba, he has harmed me. And whoever has harmed me, then he has offended Allah. He has offended Allah. And whosoever offends Allah, then soon his punishment is about to come. So these are the Sahaba, the companions of the Prophet, my dear brothers and sisters. Allah has praised these people in numerous ayat, in many ayat in the Quran. They are the best group delivered to mankind to ever exist on the face of the earth. They are the best after the prophets, after the prophets. So these were the best people, and they are role models for us. In fact, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has promised them Jannah. Allah has promised them Jannah. And He said, وَكُلًّا وَعَدَ اللَّهُ الْحُسْنَى. And for all of them, Allah has prepared Al-Husna. That is Al-Jannah for them. And He said, subhanahu wa ta'ala, about them, وَالسَّابِقُونَ الْأَوَّلُونَ مِنَ الْمُهَاجِرِينَ وَالْأَنصَارِ وَالَّذِينَ تَبَعُوهُمْ بِإِحْسَانٍ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنْهُمْ وَرَضُوا عَنْهُ وَعَدَّ لَهُمْ جَنَّاتٍ وَعَدَّ لَهُمْ جَنَّاتٍ تَجْرِي تَحْتَهَا الْأَنْهَارُ. Allah has prepared Jannah, heavens, the gardens, Jannah, paradise for the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. وَمَنْ اتَّبَعَهُمْ بِإِحْسَانٍ. And whoever followed them in goodness and righteousness, and Allah is pleased with them, Allah is happy with them. رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنْهُمْ. Allah is happy with them, and they are pleased with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَأَعَدَّ لَهُمْ جَنَّاتٍ. And Allah has prepared for them Jannah. And from their best virtue of the companions, it's simply that Allah has chosen them. In Allah Ta'ala, اختارهم. اختارهم الله لصحبة نبيه صلى الله عليه وسلم. Allah chose them to be in the companionship of His Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام. So Allah chose them for that. Allah did not choose me and you. He chose them. And this shows their high status. And Allah is Al-Hakim. He's wise. He knows what He's doing. Just as He chose the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam to be His last and final messenger, He also chose the best people to be around Him, the best companions. وقال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم خير الناس قرني. The best of people are my people, meaning my generation that I'm with right now. My generation. خير الناس قرني. Not the best Muslims, the best believers, but the best of all mankind. The best of all mankind, after all the prophets, are the companions of our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. Bismillah, alhamdulillah, wassalatu wassalamu ala rasulillah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said about these companions, radiyallahu anhum wa radu an, that Allah is pleased with them and they are pleased with Him. This is a general praise, a general verse, without any exception. Not one sahabi is exempted from this praise. And the Prophet alayhi salam, as we mentioned earlier, said, don't curse my companions. Therefore, for those groups who come about and cast doubts about Abu Bakr and Umar and any other companion, Umar and Ali and Muawiyah radiallahu anhum ajma'in, then these people, they have gone against the Quran and the Sunnah. They have gone against the word of Allah, and they have gone against the Sunnah of our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Because these are the people whom Allah chose to be around the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and Allah chose them to be the ones who took that message, the message of the Quran. They took it and they spread it and they delivered it up to this day that we have it. Allah made them a sabab. Allah made them a reason for that. Now, what about those lousy people who attack the Sahaba and they curse them and they abuse them and they offend them and they talk bad about them? My dear brothers, these are the attributes of the munafiqeen and the kuffar, of the hypocrites and the non-believers. As Allah says, وَإِذَا قِيلَ لَهُمْ آمِنُوا كَمَا آمَنَ النَّاسِ قَالُوا أَنُؤْمِنُوا كَمَا آمَنَ السُّفَهَا. If it is said to them, believe like they believed, the people, meaning the Sahaba, they said, أَنُؤْمِنُوا كَمَا آمَنَ السُّفَهَا. Should we believe like the foolish ones have believed? So mocking them, ridiculing them. But they are the ones who are, in fact, foolish. They are foolish, but they don't even realize it. Imam Malik radiallahu anhu wa rahimahullah, he said, there are predecessors, our forefathers, they used to teach their children the love of Abu Bakr and Umar like they used to teach them a surah from the Quran. This clearly shows that this love for the Sahaba and taking them as role models and following their footsteps, it is from our religion. It is from our deen. So we need to learn how to love the Sahaba of the Prophet. We need to learn how to respect them. What is the criteria to love the Sahaba? To follow their footsteps? To take them as role models? And to realize that they were also humans. They were also humans. They were not prophets. They could make mistakes. They are prone to error, like any other human is prone to error. And the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام, he said, إِذَا ذُكِرَ أَصْحَابِي فَأَمْسِكُوا. If my companions are mentioned, the Sahaba, then hold your tongue. Hold your tongue. Meaning, do not seek their faults. Do not seek their mistakes. Don't talk about their mistakes. Because no doubt they were humans. They were not prophets. So, in fact, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said about them, وَلَقَدْ عَفَى عَنْكُمْ وَلَقَدْ عَفَى عَنْكُمْ. Indeed, Allah has pardoned you. Talking about the Sahaba in Surah Al-Imran. Allah has pardoned you, the Sahaba, radiyallahu anhum ajma'in. So the whole point of this khutbah, my dear brothers and sisters, is to realize that this is part of our iman. To realize that this is part of our iman, is part of our faith, and we need to understand and learn the high status of the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And know that a non-Sahabi, a person who is not a Sahabi, who never met the Prophet, he came after, let's say, he can never attain the same status as a Sahabi, ever. He can never attain the same status as a Sahabi. And anyone who speaks ill of the Sahaba, we should be wary of those people. We should be wary of those people, and we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for guidance. And lastly, let's learn about the Sahaba. Let's learn their seerah. After we learn, of course, the seerah of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and of course, these are the men around the Messenger. And there's a book called The Men Around the Messenger. And we should all strive to get that and learn about these companions. So, because they are our role models. What do our kids watch today? Our kids, they look up to soccer stars or hockey players or whoever. But ask them about the Sahaba. Ask them, and you see what their level is. So this is, in fact, calamity. May Allah protect us and give us guidance, increase us in knowledge that has benefit. Allahumma wafiqna lima tuhibuhu wa tarda. Allahumma ja'alna hudat al-muhtadin. Allahumma ja'alna hudat al-muhtadin. Allahumma ja'alna hudat al-muhtadin. Allahumma arina al-haqqa haqqan warzuqna tiba'a. Warzuqna batil wa arina al-batila batilan warzuqna ijtinaba. Allahumma tahir qulubana min al-nifaq wa a'malina min al-riya. اللهم اشفنا واشف مرضانا والمرضى المسلمين اللهم اشف مرضانا والمرضى المسلمين اللهم اشف مرضانا ومرضى المسلمين يا رب العالمين اللهم انصر الاسلام والمسلمين اللهم انصر الاسلام والمسلمين اللهم انصر الاسلام والمسلمين واعز الاسلام والمسلمين ودمر اعداءك اعداء الدين اللهم من اراد الاسلام او المسلمين بسوء فاشغله بنفسه واجعل تدميره في تدبيره يا قوي يا عزيز إن الله تعالى يأمركم بأمر بدأ فيه بنفسه فقال جل من قال عليما إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد هذا وصلى الله على محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين والحمد لله رب العالمين واقم الصلاة